So let's take a look at how food gets contaminated. It takes several steps to get food from farm to fork. We call these steps the food production chain. Contamination can occur at any point along this chain during production, processing, distribution, and preparation. So let's take a look at production. Production means growing the plants we harvest or raising the animals that we use for food. Most food comes from domesticated animals and plants, and the production occurs on farms or ranches. Some foods are caught or harvested from the wild, such as fish, mushrooms, and game. So examples of contamination in production include a hen's reproductive organs get infected, the yolk of an egg can become contaminated in the hen even before it's laid. If fields are sprayed with contaminated water for irrigation, fruits and vegetables can become contaminated before harvest. Fish in some tropical reefs may acquire a toxin from smaller sea creatures they eat. Processing. Processing means changing plants or animals into what we recognize and buy as food. Processing involves different steps from different kinds of foods. For produce, processing can become as simple as cleaning and sorting, or even involve basic trimming, slicing or shredding and bagging. Milk is usually processed by pasteurizing it. Sometimes it's made into nuts, may be roasted, chopped or ground. For animals, the first step for processing is slaughter. Meat and poultry, may they be cut into pieces or ground. They may also be smoked, cooked or frozen, and may be combined with other ingredients to make sausage or entree, such as pot pie. So what are the examples of contamination in processing? If contaminated water or ice is used to wash, pack, or chill fruits or vegetables, the contamination can spread to those items. Peanut butter can become contaminated if roasted peanuts are stored in unclean conditions or come into contact with contaminated raw peanuts. During the slaughtering process, pathogen on an animal's hide that come into contact with the intestines can get into the final product. Let's take a look at distribution. Distribution means getting food from farm to processing plants to the consumer or food service facility, like a restaurant or hospital kitchen. This step may involve transporting foods just once, such as the trucking produce, from a farm to a local farmer's market, or it may involve many stages. For instance, frozen hamburger patties might be trucked from a meat processing plant to a larger supplier, stored for a few days in the supplier's warehouse, trucked again to a local distribution facility for a restaurant chain, and finally delivered to an individual restaurant. Examples of contamination and distribution could be from refrigerated food is left on a loading dock for too long in warm weather. These could encourage temperatures of a critical range which allow bacteria to grow. Fresh produce can be contaminated if it is loaded into a truck that was not properly cleaned and sanitized after transporting animals or animal products. The contents of a glass jar that breaks in transport can also contaminate nearby foods. Preparation. Preparation means getting foods ready to eat. This step may occur in the kitchen of a restaurant, home, or institution. It may involve following a complex recipe with many ingredients, simple heating, and serving on a plate, or just opening a package and eating the food. Examples of contamination in food preparation includes a food handler stays on the job while he or she is sick and does not wash his hands or her hands carefully after using the toilet or handling raw meat. If a cook uses a cutting board or knife to cut raw chicken and then uses the same knife or cutting board without washing to slice tomatoes, could cause possible cross-contamination from the chicken. Contamination can occur within a refrigerator if meat juices get into contact with any other items. Mishandling at multiple points. By the time food causes illness, it may have been mishandled in several ways along the production chain. Once a contamination occurs, further mishandling of food, such as undercooking the food or leaving out at ambient temperatures, can allow an outbreak to be more likely. Many pathogens grow quickly in food held at room temperature, and a tiny number can grow to a large number in just a few hours. Reheating foods after items have been left out at room temperature for long times may not always be the final answer due to pathogens that produce toxins that are not destroyed by heat. Therefore, it is absolutely imperative to follow all the food safety pillars in order to ensure that a solid foundation of safe food can be built.